Because I went to Kwansei Gakuin, the institution, which had a university. It's a Kwansei Gakuin University. I went to the high school of that university. So therefore, when I finished high school, I automatically could have gone to university, the same university. And I guess because my brother came back, but I also, somewhere inside me, said, well, you know, I was born in Canada, you know, and I can go back to Canada. I don't know if there was any stronger motivation, but I said, yes, I think I'll go back. But I was also aware that I knew nothing about Canada. I didn't know what happened to the Japanese when the war started. I didn't know, you know, I knew very little about Canada because, you know, when you're seven, you don't know anything. And then I went to Japan, so. But I still, somewhere inside me, said that, well, you know, you can be a Canadian or that's where you were born. So I came back after high school and my English was very nominal. I didn't, you know, I spoke better English than the other students, but I didn't speak very fluent English. First of all, the airplane, Canadian Pacific Airlines, started to fly from Vancouver to Haneda in 1949, very early. But nobody, or most people, could not afford the airfare. In 1955 or 56, the round-trip airfare between Vancouver and Japan, Haneda, was about $950. And that's a lot of money. So most people, and also around 1950 to 1955, there weren't many Japanese that could come to Canada. There weren't many, there were only the Japanese Canadians who were in Japan that may have wanted to come back to Canada. But they could not afford the airfare. So my brother, for instance, he came back to Canada via San Francisco because there was nothing between Japan and Vancouver. And so when I was ready to come back, I had my brother in Canada knew a person, a Japanese in Vancouver, who had some connections to Japanese shipping companies. So my brother asked this person if he could make any kind of arrangements for me to come back on a freighter that would arrive in Vancouver. So I came back on a freighter. Everything was new to me. I came back, but I knew I had to try to belong, you know. I knew I was different, because I just come from Japan and my English was not fluent, so I would be different. And it was not multicultural, multi-ethnic Canada, you know. In Vancouver it was basically Anglo-Canadian, you know, dominated. So, no, I think I was trying very hard. Trying very hard to become a Canadian, but just trying very hard to be one of them. So my first job I had worked in a cabinet maker because I guess, you know, because of my father's trade, being a carpenter and so forth, I worked in a cabinet making place at Main Street and 29th. In fact, they made televisions in Vancouver then. And I was working in the assembly to make the television cabinets. I guess I wanted to follow my father's kind of footsteps. and I was very interested in the working in a sawmill, and I wanted to become a forest engineer. So I thought, well, and UBC was well known for its forestry department. So I thought, well, I'll work in a sawmill, and during the summer I'll work, and then in the winter I'll go to UBC. So I went to 2 years. I did not finish in forestry because I got interested in other businesses. But I worked in a sawmill, I worked in a logging camp for 4 to 5 seasons, which is now Whistler. But I enjoyed, you know, working in that to learn about the sawmill, the sawmill work, or the logging camp, you know, work in the logging camp. So that was from 1953 till 1956, yeah.